challenge was the best one yet. It got us thinking about how we use, transport and dispose of water, a highly valuable resource.
Our team is from Geelong in Australia, and our city has always been reliant on industries for jobs. Companies such as Shell, Alcoa and Ford have left Geelong to take their businesses offshore because it is cheaper. So we want to find a new way to create jobs.
In line with our local government's initiative to promote tourism and technology in our regions, we have come up with the idea to build a totally sustainable tourist attraction at Point Henry, the old location of Alcoa, about 3 minutes from our school.
This area has beautiful bay views and is surrounded by water. The attraction will have really cool gardens similar to Singapore's trees. This will bring many tourists to our region. We contacted the designers of the Singapore City trees and they sent us in this sketch.
Whilst we could scale down the calculations to make our conceptual model, it told us nothing about the irrigation system. The team identified this was a true problem, designing an irrigation system to respond to the inconsistent Australian weather patterns.
While Singapore's climate remains fairly stable at 31 degrees all year round, Australia's weather patterns can go from 2 to 45 degrees, meaning in the winter months we get lots of rain. Being the summer months, it could be weeks before we see a drop of water. We had to design an irrigation system to give us enough water all year round.
After discussing our ideas with the engineers from Barwonville, we realised that our first prototype, based on the Coolgardie Center, was not sophisticated enough to meet the water demands. We needed to rethink our solution. How can we change the design to make every water drop count?
Installing water tanks at the top and bottom of our vertical gardens might just be the answer to our problem. We could collect water during the winter months and store it for the summer months. We could use gravity and pipes to move the water from the top tank to the underground water storage area at the bottom.
After meeting with a botanist, we decided to use hydroponics and saplings, which meant that we needed to pump up nutrients up the system once a month.
We installed a water release valve at the top tank to move water between tanks. As the top tank holds 10,000 litres and the bottom tank holds 30,000 litres, we can add nutrients to the bottom tank before using our solar powered generator to pump the water back up.
Each team member identified solar panels as a design strength. We took this one step further by adding movable solar panels that follow the direction of sun. This gave us the power necessary to run our generators.
We replaced the Coolgardie Safe with an atmospheric water generator, or AWG for short. As all air contains water, the AWG will let us harvest water in the air over the summer months, especially in periods of high humidity. The AWG sucks humid air through the sides of the vertical gardens and condenses it by cooling it below its dew point. This then reduces the humid air's capacity to carry water vapor, and the byproduct is water.
In addition to collecting water from the AWG, if we move the machine up the tree, any steam produced from this machine would be trapped at the top of the tree. This third system would allow steam to rise up to the cone-shaped coal plate and then drip down into our pipes. As water is a sticky substance, we added hessian so that the water would stick together and then flow down into our pipes.
The water would then travel down our pipes and run into each catchment area on the way down to the bottom of the tree.
As a team, we believe that we have not only answered the hydrodynamics challenge, but have potentially solved a major problem within our area.
Our hydrodynamics idea was mentioned at the Victorian State Parliament and reached almost 6,500 views through the City of Greater Geelong's website. We have created a virtual tour using Unity of Point Henry, used Arduino to light up our super trees, and turned our vision for the irrigation system into reality using the CAD program Fusion 360.
We've met many incredible experts who have deepened our knowledge about water.
Travelled across the world to see the Singapore super trees in real life.
And presented to esteemed judges at the international competition.
Regardless of how you're today.
As a team, we've already achieved more than we can hope for.
Arriba!